everyone, my name is Python and welcome back to another episode of my Minecraft Survival Let's Play. Now guys, thank you so much once again for the support you have been showing for this series, my friends. So very much appreciated as per the norm, guys. And don't forget, if you guys are still excited for the series and you want to continue showing your love for this Minecraft Survival series, do be sure to head down below the video and drop a like rating. Now guys, today's fan art comes from a user by the name of khenry242, and what he decided to do is something pretty awesome. He decided to sketch out my Minecraft creeper character holding a grass block as if to say, I'm gonna blow that thing up. And yeah, the fire behind it kind of pays testament to that. So yeah, that was a thing. Wait, what the heck was that? Oh! His helmet just ran out. I didn't know that. So their helmet, when they're in daytime, loses durability up until the point where the helmet breaks and then they dive sunlight anyway. I did not know that. And now I do. That is pretty awesome. Okay, sweet. But yeah, guys, thank you so much, khenry. I do appreciate the fan art, buddy. And of course, guys, fan art email is on screen if you wish to send it in. You can also send it in through Twitter if you wish to as well. And of course, you guys, there'll have a chance of yours being used and your name shouted out. Now, guys, today we are going to hopefully make ourselves a bunch of progress regarding this town. Okay, so what I want to do is I want to go ahead and make a start and making a pathway slash staircase going from here all the way down, wrapping around as I mentioned in a previous episode. So yeah, this should be pretty darn awesome. I'm actually kind of excited to get this thing started. One thing I do want to do is just quickly amend that. There we go. And yeah, this is where the staircase is going to start. We're going to be getting rid of this entire crop area here, maybe move it somewhere else. I did mention maybe moving it to a different location, so we'll probably go ahead and do that. This place here, I'm going to leave it as a dead end, but I'm going to sort of decorate it a bit more and sort of secure it so you know, no mobs can get in here. The only thing I'm thinking of though is maybe they can get in through the stairs here. Well, I need to redo the roof here anyways, just so it looks a bit nicer, but this is basically going to be like a dead end. I don't think I'm going to lead this anywhere, unless I do eventually, in which case, you know, we'll have to see in future, but that's something to come later on. But yeah, we're going to go ahead and we're gonna make a start on this thing, guys. We're finally going to make a start on getting a pathway going down. Get our first official staircase going, guys. It is going to be freaking sweet. And then obviously what I've also got here is a whole bunch of fence materials, because as you can see, this is just a sheer cliff at the moment. We need to go ahead and amend that, make it into a proper thing. Can I? Gosh darn it. No, I want to... This won't work. Okay, boom. There we go. That got you, didn't you, you little butt? You can't stay away from me forever, can you? Oh, dear. All right, so yeah, we're going to go ahead and make a whole bunch of progress regarding, you know, securing this town, basically. We want to get a whole bunch of fences going, the same fence design as we have been using for the rest of the entire thing, pretty much. And yeah, we're going to go ahead and make as much progress as we possibly can. And hopefully, as a result of doing all that, we should be able to eventually let our villagers actually roam around the town like they should be. So, yeah. So I've just noticed something, guys. Because I made this place so high up, the bed is so high up off the ground, no matter if there's mobs around me, I can still sleep. That's actually really, really cool. So I could just literally escape into my tower, go to sleep, and then I can come downstairs and everybody's on fire. That is quite a good prospect, to be honest. Get wrecked. There we go. Look, everybody just got killed. Everybody got killed. Amazing. Alright guys, so this is the progress I've made. I have had to make a slight amendment to the design of the fence in that I've had to put like a double post here in order to sort of keep the symmetry. But as you can see, the fence post design is in fact in place and everything's looking good. So now guys, what we're going to do is we need to revert back to the design which we're using for the water pathways. The one that involves the birchwood slabs, the cobble stairs, all that kind of stuff. So, let's go ahead and put away the stuff we don't really need. We've got the spruce wood slabs there. That's all looking good. I'm going to make myself a bunch of slabs like this. There we go, looking good. Alright, so, I can probably make myself one more little load. Yeah, okay, cool. Right, I don't want to use up too much inventory space is the point I want to make. There we go, let's put that in there. Those are temporary project tests. So I've also put one down there as well. So, yeah. But in terms of this pathway, just to remind you guys, what is going to be happening is we're going to revert back to the birch wood spruce logs design that we had before. It's going to wrap all the way around here. I'm probably going to keep this. I don't know. I don't know if I want to keep this. I might keep it. You guys were suggesting that we make a dock. Oh, jeez! Wow. My knockback sword actually just saved my life right there. Holy guacamole. Oh my god. That was some proper quick thinking there, folks. Holy crap. I'm actually kind of impressed with myself. But yeah, you guys were suggesting I go ahead and make a dock out of this, which is a very, very good idea. I will, of course, actually go ahead and do that. That is something that I've got on my list of things to do. But yeah, going back to the pathway, it's going to wrap all the way around here, all the way over to this house. And the pathway is going to continue going through here. It's going to go all the way around here. There's another creeper. Ha-boom! Get wrecked. And it's going to go all the way over here where it's going to go back onto the ground, convert itself into a normal pathway, and then it is going to join up over here. So yeah, it is basically going to be a humongous loop. It's going to be a humongous loop which we can run around, go ahead and get to all the places that we need to get to, and it will all be good to go. So let's go ahead and get back to, you know, reverting to the original pathway designs. So a little bit of this, a little bit of this. We're going to need ourselves a bunch of cobble stairs as well. What don't I really need? I'm going to go ahead and take off the bow. There we go. Looking good. All right. So let's go ahead and get over here. Let's start replacing this. I don't know if I want to make the entire stairway. Oh, wait. Hang on a minute. I just want to go ahead and... that's going to annoy me if I know that's there. But yeah, what I need to go ahead and do is I need to put some of these bad boys down. There we go. Looking good, isn't it? So as you guys know, the pathway is only like 2 blocks wide. So that is what we're going to be going for. And yeah, as you can see, we're just going ahead and doing exactly what we did on the first few episodes out of this series. We're just going ahead and making the platform going all the way around. Okay, pretty simple thing to do. Pretty easy to follow. One thing I'm not entirely sure about is if I want to go ahead and convert these into birch slabs as well. I'm actually thinking that yes is going to be the answer to that question. I don't know. We'll have to figure something out here. But yeah, here we go. Let's go ahead and grab out some of these bad boys. Ha-boom, ha-boom, ha-boom. And then a little bit of that. And then, of course, we've got the fenceway. So 1, 2, 3. Yeah, okay. And then another pillar. Rather like this. Okay. And then we go ahead once again. Roll around here like so. And then we get another... Wait, hang on. That's not a post, is it? That's a bunch of slabs. I don't want the slabs. I want this. I want the pillar. There we go. Fantastic. Okay. And then once again, a little bit of that. Oh, a little bit of that. And then around the corner. And then another post. Rather like this. Hey. But yeah, you get the general gist of what I'm doing. Hopefully by now, folks. We're just reverting back to the design we used on the first few episodes. And yeah, let's get some torches in here. Just so there's a bit of light going on around here. And yeah, you might notice that this is sort of slimmed down from 3 blocks wide to 2 blocks wide. That is indeed the intended effect. I'm going to make a fence kind of thing here as well. Don't you worry your faces about it. But for now, we're going to go ahead and make a big push. Okay, we're going to make a big push to try and get this pathway done. I'm going to make a bunch of progress, hopefully, I guess. And yeah, I'll bring you guys back once I have made a bunch of progress. I need to dig out just a little bit here, just a little section. There we go. All right, we're looking good now, folks. We're looking good. Okay, right, like I said, I'm gonna make a bunch of progress. I'm gonna try and get as much of this pathway done, and I'll bring you guys back in just a mo. All right, guys, progress update. As you can see, a decent amount of this pathway has now been completed. As you can see, it now wraps all the way around. I haven't quite got to the stage where I've got to the tunnel yet, but that's going to be my next thing to do in today's episode. But as you can see, I've got the staircase all sorted out and all figured out in terms of design, which is really, really awesome. Let's just head over there real quick, just so we can have a bit of a walk around it. As you can see, I actually left in the tree that was here. In fact, there's 2 trees here. Okay, cool. So yeah, this area, we've got ourselves the little mini village area. We're going to start going ahead and doing a little bit of this, and then obviously that turns into wood right there, because of course, you know, there's the thing going on there. Although, when I think about it, I might go ahead and replace this with grass, actually. Well, that'd be a cool idea. We'll get some grass in here, then we can convert it, of course, into the path blocks, which is kind of awesome. So let's go ahead in here, maybe dig out a couple grass blocks right here. Obviously, my pickaxe is the only silk touch thing I have currently, so that is why I'm doing that. But yeah, let's just do a little bit of this. Alright, looking good, folks, looking good. Okay, so that's all grassed over, just waiting for this little block here to grass over, and then we'll be good to go. But as you can see, it sort of goes down to a regular village pathway here. We've got a little house down here, which is awesome. I've fenced off this area here, which is really, really cool. And then, of course, all we need to do now is make it go through this little cove here. You can see I've opened it up a little bit, and everything is looking awesome. So yeah, let's go ahead and have a bit of a walkthrough here. As you can see, like I said, the same design we used on the original, you know, just above the water pathways, and then we've got the staircase here, and then of course the entrance into the village. Now obviously I want to try and make this bit a little bit wider, and I'm thinking what I do is I chop off a block here, so I make it one block less wide, I guess. So I'll chop off this entire layer here, and then that'll leave us a two block wide gap to get in here, so of course I can maybe, you know, take my horse down here and all that kind of stuff. Take Goldie down, man, take him out for a walk. It's been a while, huh? But yeah, guys, everything's looking good. Everything is looking good. My resources are starting to look not so good, admittedly. But, you know, that's not to say I can't still make a bunch of progress. Oh! Hey, brother. Oh, hey. Hi. Hi. Here's what I'm going to go and do. I'm going to go and lure the... Oh, jeez. He's noticed me. He's freaking noticed me. All right, come on, buddy. Come on. Come on. I'm ready. Don't do it. Don't do it. If you blow me up, I'm going to be a mad, mad python. Don't you do it. Don't you do it. I want to kill those... I want to kill those Endermen. All right, here we go. So, both of you. Here we go. I'm awaiting. Come on. Come on. Keep it going. Keep it going. I'm going to get your balls. I'm going to get your balls. Come on. Come on, man. Oh, thank you very much. Oh, yeah, buddy. All right, how about you? Come on then, brother. Oh, jeez, man. Hey, buddy. I'm getting all these ender balls, man. This is amazing. Okay, so there's more than one down there. Huh. All right, and then he dropped a few as well. But are there any more? You don't see Endermen spawn in the overworld in packs very often, though. It's not an often sight to see, basically. Right, let me go ahead and just fill that back in. There we go. Okay, and we need to chuck something out. Not gunpowder, because I kind of like that. Do we have, like, any other crappy stuffs? I don't know, man. I kind of want it all. There we go. Let's have that. Wow, we got 5 Enderballs from 2 Endermen. Awesome. All right, so yeah, guys, we're gonna make ourselves a whole bunch more progress updates and stuff, and yeah, we're gonna do well. Basically, we're gonna make a bunch of progress. I'll bring you guys back once I have made some progress, and hopefully we can get this pathway done. Alright guys, so it is now time to connect up these two pathways. We've got the pathway there, and then of course we've got the extension pathway over here. And by the way, as you can see, progress update, we got this thing pretty much done. I actually extended the waterway inside this place quite a lot, so it's actually, you know, above water like it should be. So yeah, it's looking good. Oh no, I just want to make a slight adjustment. There we go. Sweet. Okay, so made a decent amount of progress, and boy oh boy, I'm feeling good about this. I'm feeling good about this. The only way people could possibly get in here is if they maybe spawn on this roof here, or they somehow drop down like in a precision kind of way and they wind up down here. So yeah, but whatever the case may be, everything is looking good. And yeah, we got ourselves a bunch of the pathway materials. We're gonna go with the same pathway design as with over here beside the water. So yeah, I guess I need to kind of wait for this to grass over, actually, as a matter of fact. Unless I go somewhere else and just pick up some grass blocks. I mean, you know, that's also a possibility, a thing we could do, guys. So what we're going to do while we're doing this, ladies and gentlemen, is we're going to jump into the comment question of the video, which comes from Angus Chan. Python, you should build a ravine town with villagers roaming around when you find a ravine. So, yeah, this is one of the ideas that I've had flowing around my mind for a fair while, actually. Trying to convert a ravine into some sort of town which is fit to have villages. Now, there's already a whole bunch of challenges that comes with trying to make a village in a ravine. Like, the houses need to have direct sunlight, right, in order for the villagers to breed and class them as houses. So there would be the challenge of trying to find a way of making sure that there's direct sunlight on all of the houses. And as well as that, you know, there's the challenge of the ravine itself, like the challenge of building, because it's all, you know, sheer cliffs and all that kind of stuff. So, you know, I imagine, you know, it'll be quite the challenge, but I also think that it will be quite a fun challenge because it's something I've never personally done before. I think I may have, like, attempted it on some of my personal worlds previously, but I didn't really get anywhere with them because my personal worlds are pretty short-lived because, well, I kind of like, you know, recording what I do, you know? I like recording what I do on my Minecraft world so I can show you guys, and yeah, that's just kind of how it is there, really. Right, I want to try and make sure this pathway's got a nice amount of width to it, so, you know, everything's looking good. And then, you know, once we have this thing done, everything will be good, man. There we go. Let's just continue down here. And then what we're going to do is we're going to do exactly the same as what we've done here. And we're just going to, like, muss it up a bit, mess it up a bit, do all that kind of stuff. You know how it is. So this time, we don't really have the challenge of having water next to us. So we can literally just place this stuff anywhere we want, which is really quite awesome, actually. So we need to make sure that they're not in any kind of pattern, because that is not really what I want to go for. So what we're going to do is just randomly place this stuff in here. We want to kind of have the central pathway, you know, the path blocks still sort of signifying the fact that that stuff is there, if you get what I mean. But you know, apart from that, I just want to go ahead and randomize this stuff. So a little bit there, maybe we can have a little bit, you know, just in here, a little bit here, maybe a little bit more, like, on the sides over this side, you know? Then that'd be kind of cool. And then a little bit more there. And then, of course, we'll switch to the coarse dirt, do pretty much the same. Yeah, I think this is going to look really, really good once done. And what we need to try and figure out is how we're going to prevent mobs from being able to walk in here. Now, probably the easiest way is by going ahead and doing a similar kind of fence design to this, or sort of a loose fence design, by not allowing mobs to be able to walk in here. I mean, baby mobs could probably walk in here, actually. I need to go ahead and sort that out, like, pretty much right now. There we go. That's looking decent, isn't it? So, well, then again, they could just walk on top. Okay, we need to make sure that they can't actually get up anywhere. Basically, if I can get up, then so can they. So, yeah, the little adjustment that I made there should mean that they won't be able to get up, right? Yeah, sounds good. I might go ahead and replace this with a leaf as well. Yeah, okay, cool. And then I need to do something there, don't I? Okay, right. I'm going to put another piece of coarse dirt down because why not? There we go. I kind of messed it up a bit, didn't I? Alright, cool. So, let's go ahead and continue on with this. Let's go ahead and work on the sides over here just a little bit. Maybe add a little bit more there. A little bit here. And here. And maybe just a little bit just in here. Yeah, it's looking good. And then a bit there. We'll try and use all of these blocks up. Oh my good lord, that was a major squeak, wasn't it? Holy crap. Holy, that was bad. That was bad. Holy god. Okay, right. So we've got 9 jungle leaves. I don't think we're going to be able to get ourselves a very substantial amount of stuff done here, unfortunately. But we're going to do the same sort of thing as we did before with the fences and whatnot, so that's gonna look kind of cool. Right, they can get over there currently. Right, you guys were saying before that double tall fences weren't really working in our favor, so I'll take that in consideration and I will make sure that I don't do that again. So something like this. No, that's a bit too far in, I think. Yeah, okay, looking good. And we'll continue on with putting some torches in here. And we need to get some more leaves. That is one thing that is becoming present to me, like, is I really, really need to get some leaves in, guys. Okay, right. I don't want to have any fences coming in here because I don't think that'll make a great deal of sense, realistically speaking. A little bit there, and then maybe a little bit there. Okay, cool. And again, with the torches, just place them in like so, just so there's a bit of light on this pathway. And then, yeah. Alright, so all I need to do is I need to grab myself out a pair of shears, which I do believe is going to be my tools chest. I'm going to grab some leaves. We're going to go ahead and do the exact same design as here. We're going to grab some bone meal out as well, just so we can get the design going that way as well. And then, yeah, we'll be good to go in terms of that pathway, man. Hey, man, I'm feeling pretty good about the fact we've got that pathway done and the staircase. Pretty darn good indeed. Alright guys, and here we are. I think I've just about got this thing good and done. I need to, of course, go ahead and do the same over here. Where this pathway is going to go, basically, is going to wrap all the way around this lake here, and it's going to connect up with this, okay? That's the plan. So basically this entire lake is sort of colonized, I guess. And we need to go ahead and make sure that the fence goes all the way around it as well, so no mobs can get in. That is the plan anyway, so yeah, man, everything's looking good. We got this pathway good and done. We can go ahead and have a big old walk through it now, or a big old run. We can have a bit of a go up here. There's the pathway spanning all the way around here. You can follow it all the way around, and then you can get yourself back up into the town real easily. And best of all, it's all lit up, so no mobs at all should be able to spawn, which is really, really awesome. Of course, like I said, we need to go ahead and, you know, chop a little bit off this house, but, you know, that's something for another episode. That's totally fine and dandy. Pretty easy thing to do. But the only other thing I wanted to show you guys was I decided to do a little bit of this. Look at this. This is eventually going to be a pathway, which I think should be able to connect up with the mine entrance, okay? I imagine this thing can connect up with the mine entrance pretty nicely. It's basically going to be like an underground pathway, and I think it's going to be really quite awesome. So, I can't even get back up now. That's how secure this place is. I can't even get back into my own village now. That is fantastic, isn't it? Oh, dear, oh, dear. But, yeah, there we go, guys. Oh, this is looking good, isn't it? Like, our town is really starting to take shape. I'm really liking the fence designs. I'm really liking the pathway designs we've got going on here. This guy is, like, go away. Go away. I mean, why you still do this? Why are you still trying to get my stuff? Hey, Bobby. How you doing there, buddy? Just bobbing around like the Bobby that he is. Oh, dear. But it is amazing how much progress we've made on this town. I'm really, really happy with it. Hopefully, you guys are too. And, yeah, ladies and gentlemen, I think on that note, on my creeper brother killing note, it is going to be time to end this episode here, my friends. Thank you very much for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this episode, and of course you are excited to see more, be sure, of course, to drop a like rating and hit that subscribe button if you don't want to miss out on my future content. But for now, my friends, it is going to be time for me to head off. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next episode.